What's up, guys? This is Balázs from Racing Brick. I was really glad to see the kind responses from you after the release of the Powered Up Code Block guides. I hope you will be able to use them in many exciting projects. Today, I want to show you again something cool and hopefully useful for Powered Up, but let's see the background story first. We know the Top Gear Rally Car and the Extreme Adventure sets with their Factory Control Plus app. It works well, but it is totally closed. There are no customization options at all. If I want to plug in a single light, then the app will refuse to start, but I couldn't use it anyway without any buttons. If I want to build a custom car, then I have to stick to the exact same motor configuration of one of these sets, otherwise I could not control it properly. LEGO promised us to have the customization options in the Powered Up app, well, more about that in a minute. I think the most flexible solution at the moment is still the Brick Controller 2 app. You could see that working in my previous videos. If you miss them, then you can click on the link in the top right corner to watch them. This app works great, it has proper return to center steering for cars, there are constant updates and refinements released by the developer, but it only works with a gamepad. For me, it is the best feature and definitely not a disadvantage, but I know there are folks out there who would like to have controllers within the app itself. The Boovies app sort of works, but it still lacks proper return to center steering, and it only connects to the Technic hub, so it's not a full solution yet. Let's get back to the Powered Up app. I was really waiting for the 3.0 update last December. I was hoping to get a solution finally for a simple vehicle control, which I think should be a day one feature built in. Unfortunately, it was still not included in the update. As you probably know, we still don't have simple blocks or control interfaces for steering, and it's still a challenge to figure out these things in the app due to the lack of documentation. Hopefully, the code block guide will be useful for such scenarios. It definitely helped me to figure out a usable solution. It took me a few weeks to test and refine the different versions, but finally I managed to come up with a solution that works most of the time. This is still not a 100% reliable or foolproof solution, and I still had to deal with the limitations of the environment, but it works okay and I tried to make it customizable. Please don't expect this to be a perfect final solution, but rather an experiment that shows how can we achieve the basic functionality of the Control Plus app with the 3.0 version of the Powered Up app. If you want to test the code immediately and you only want to watch the details afterwards, then check the description of the video or the highlighted comment. There's a link to the free PDF guide to create the working code with the two different interfaces in the Powered Up app. Based on my experience, despite the awkward orientation, the slider interface actually works better. The joystick is simply too small for precise control, and the type of blocks available currently make it difficult to steer and accelerate at the same time precisely. So let's see the details. Just as a reminder, this is the simple behavior we'd like to replicate in the Powered Up app. We need to be able to control the forward and backward motion, we need proper return to center steering and the calibration process that will set the center position of the motor used for steering. What were the problems to be solved within the Powered Up app? Well, first of all, the behavior of the block that turns the motor to a specific angle. By default, it is not precise enough, there's a significant overshoot effect. Here you can see the block that reports the current angle. It is most of the time different from the value set. If I set a lower speed, then the situation is improved, but that requires a really low setting and it becomes unusable for steering. If I add a loop and use the controller sliders to simulate the steering, then you can see that there are precision problems and the reaction is very choppy. It is possible to improve this with the blocks that change the ramp up and ramp down speed. The result is a much faster reaction, but then there's a constant rumbling remaining. This is caused by the loop that is required to run the code constantly. Due to the overshoot effect, the motor has a hard time turning to the exact value set, and it jumps back and forth until it finally finds the exact position. If I set the speed back to a lower value, then the trembling stops faster, but the turning speed again becomes very slow. Additionally, the return to center function is not achievable easily, as the app only has access to the relative zero position and not the absolute zero position. This means that the zero position will always become the one where the motor is when it is turned on. So let's see the solution that hopefully eliminates most of these problems. I won't go into the tiniest details, but I will try to summarize the main steps. First of all, the input value from the slider had to be averaged. There are only 10 positions now in each direction, but it is usually enough to control a vehicle. The block that controls the motors needed to be separated from the main loop and only triggered if there's a change in the slider's position. This way, it is triggered really only when needed, and there's no constant trembling anymore. There's a calibration process since the zero position is not known by default. The calibration turns the wheels to maximum left and right, then calculates the central position between the two and sets it as zero. The calibration is started with a long press of the first button. When you start the app, the zero position becomes automatically the position where the wheels are. So if the wheels were centered properly, then there's no need to run the calibration every time. In case if the calibration is not precise enough, it is possible to fine-tune the center position with the two other buttons. Once the calibration is complete, the car can be steered using the right slider. I know the orientation is not ideal, but I find it easier to use than the joystick on the other controller screen. The speed of steering currently depends on the angle difference between the two positions. This was set to reduce the effect of the overshooting behavior. Additionally, there's an extra adjustment of the position if the slider is set to zero to ensure the car will really go straight. Since there are only three buttons available, I had to be a little bit creative with the controls. The first button has two different functions assigned. With a long press, you can start the calibration process that is indicated by the light on the hub flashing orange. With a short tap on the button, you can turn on and off the lights attached, or you can set it to any other function you prefer. On the controller screen, you can see the speed displayed on the left side and the steering speed on the right side. It's fairly easy to reconfigure the code for another car. You only need to change the values in the top left corner. I included the configuration for both sets in the PDF file. About the PDF, there are high resolution screenshots that you can recreate in your app. On the first page, you can see it without any additional information. On the second one, I added information to each block explaining how they work. It is advised to zoom in and you can read the information easier. There's also a sample code for the joystick interface. I prefer the slider one as it is easier to control for me. The joystick has a weird behavior, I could not create a better configuration for it yet. Since there are four buttons on this screen, the first one has the light switch and the calibration is assigned to the red button. There are a few remaining issues, like the position reading sometimes fails and does not return any values, or the slider won't respond after starting the program. If you encounter these, then please simply try to restart the application and reconnect the hub. I hope you will be able to use the sample code to create your own custom interface. It can be adapted to other custom creations as well, even with a different hub, so it is really customizable. Unfortunately, you still need to understand how the code works, so it's not as easy as the configuration of other apps like Brick Controller 2, but it is a small step forward. I hope we will see dedicated blocks for these functions in the future that will eliminate the need for such complicated code. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you want to see more tech reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time. Bye bye.